Hello, and welcome to CopTubeAmerica.com, where we teach you the elements of criminal law. Hello, teens, 13 to 17. All right, remember, I shared with you about choices. There are choices that you make, and your parents stop you all the time, because they know if you do this, like dominoes, this will happen. Now, they may not share that with you entirely, but I'm going to share it with you. Do not fault them and do not punish them, all right, like a lot of teens do. Parents are not perfect. They got so much to do, they don't even realize they have to get you in school. They have to make sure you got all your shots. Where do you have a kid? If you have a kid, then you're going to say, oh, I'm sorry. Just let it go now. All right, they have to make sure you're following school rules, church rules if you go to church, grandpa's rules, grandma's rules, rules over there, next door neighbor, don't walk on the sidewalk, don't walk on their sidewalk, don't go on their grass, they could be having a fit, whatever rules they got. Everybody got rules. Plus, they have to make sure that they don't break the law themselves. Wow! Because if they do, social services will get a hold of you, then you're through foster care. You're through that system. Parents got a lot to do. All my mother does is sit down there and she don't do nothing. Yes, she does something. Stop it. Don't be so insulting as a teenager either. That's one thing I don't like about teens now. We love you. Oh, America loves you for real. But we don't like when teenagers insult their parents or insult other adults, because you're going to get out here in this adult world and you're going to mess up too. Everybody got a little blemish on their white garments. And there's nobody here that's perfect. So you got to go to your parents and say, I'm sorry. I didn't mean no harm. You know, I learned. You guys got to think about a whole lot why kids are thinking about themselves. No, I got that one right. While you're thinking about yourself, they're thinking about you. What kind of sense does that make? It's all one-sided to me. And it's not cool and it's not fair. Some kids say, I think about my mom all the time. I think about my dad all the time. But they don't think about me. Yes, they do. That's probably why they're in the depressed mode they in. Oh, look what they have to go through. Sit down. I want you guys to write it down. First of all, you had to be carried for 9 months, or give or take. All right, that's the average. Now listen, then when she had to eat healthy, she had to make sure she didn't fall, because that had damaged you. She can't have no weed, no drugs of any sort or any kind in her system, no prescription drugs, anything. I don't care if she's on medication for any type of mental illness. She can't be healthy because she has to do what? She can't take drugs. She has to maintain her cleanliness, or her the womb has to be clean. It can't. Her blood has to be kept pure as it can be. All right, that's what the doctors want. Now listen. All right, now when you come out, there's a whole lot of paperwork. Okay, there's a whole lot of paperwork got to be filed. Then there's a whole lot of shots, and those shots have to be filed. There's a lot of doctor's appointments. And then in between the doctor's appointment, they got to watch you. They got to hold you, keep you warm, and keep you cool. They got to change diapers. They got to teach you how to walk. They got to teach you how to not poo-poo and pee-pee in your diapers. They got to teach you how to go to the bathroom. Then they got to fight with you if you don't want to sit down, because they don't taught you how to walk. Because you fail all the time, you don't realize that. Before you really learn successfully how to walk, you're going to stumble, you're going to fall, you're going to hold on to things. Sorry they don't have every picture for every second, every moment that they were raising you. Oh, then you go, you're teething. Oh my goodness. Oh. And you call your parents' names, they've been through hell. And I dare anybody to say, well, this shouldn't have happened. You're going to be the ones with 14, 15, 16, 20 kids. And they're going to all love you. And you're going to have everything to worry about. Don't be that smart-mouthed kid. Don't do that. It's not nice. It really isn't nice. Okay, now listen. Then they got to make sure before you get, now someone got to be christened. They got to go through that. Do you know in between time they are losing sleep because they are so worried about you? Then they got to worry about sins. Or if you'll turn over and go to sleep on your belly. Oh, my goodness, if they find you on your belly. Oh, they panic. Because then if you end up in a hospital, a lack of oxygen, no brain damage, or you end up dead in a morgue, all that's got to be investigated. So let's deal with the living. Now they have to buckle you in and you got to stay in a child safety seat until about the age of 6, or they go by a certain weight. All right, now, they got to make sure you ain't putting any and everything in your mouth. And if you got a little brother, little sister, guess what? You go, yeah, that is right. Wow. Yeah, they got to keep after you. Then they got to hopefully, that's what they do, they hope. And they're going to hopefully, oh, Lord. Yes. They got to hopefully get you through all that. Watch this. All that before kindergarten or daycare. And before you go to daycare, because they want you to be smart. Say thank you sometime. Because you wanted all that from me. Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am. And I'm tired. Shoot. The United States push you. Boy, the United States. They on it. Just get some kids going. All right, now watch. Then, they're losing sleep all along now. They got to get up in the morning. They got to make sure you got clothes on your back and shoes on your feet. And they don't have to be the latest things. They got to make sure you get 3 meals. Wow. They got to make sure you're drinking water. They got to make sure that you're not, like I said, putting things in your mouth that'll make you sick. They got to make sure that you're not licking your snot. Stop that. Ew. And they got blow. I don't want to blow. Blow. Why is that blow? Just listen. All they had to go through. Getting pregnant was easy for some. We haven't even gotten you to daycare. All right? You have to learn ABCs. Wow, and repeat and get them all right and in order. How to count. You have to know your colors. You have to know what up means and what down means. You have to learn left and right. There's a lot of things you have to learn. Plus, he or she has to go to work as well and lose sleep and come home and fix food and make sure that everything is straight. Wow, because social services coming in the house is nasty. She can lose you. It ain't like it used to be. All right, so then we get you into, wait a minute. She can't leave nothing out. You might swallow it, putting things in your mouth. She can't let you near. She can't leave a lighter, or your dad can't leave a lighter around. You can't leave your shoes out because the kid's playing shoes. Here to go stumbling down the stairs. Trying to be big feet. Wow. You have to have locks on everything because kids get into everything and the parent can be accused or arrested for neglect. Here we go in the family court. Mother and fathers can't be fighting around kids because that teaches a child how to what? Be repeat. See, I told you kids are repeaters. All right? You have to have your own mind. All right, now I think, did we get somewhere close? And then you got the in-laws, or you got the grandma and grandpa, and they want you to know everything about the family and then some. Then you got to go to the museum and then to the water parks, and you got to see everything in America. And then you can't run in the street, but you got to learn how to play ball. And if they think you're going to be tall, then they got to get you ready for the NBA. Then, well, the kid should have a talent. What's their talents, what's their skills, what's their abilities? Life is really all about you them first few years. Whew. Then you got to get a haircut. Then you got to get your hair in Brett's. And she got to brush your hair. So you have a good head of hair when you get older. Then your bed got to be made. And if you pee in the bed, then that the mattress. Oh! Am I finished yet? And are y'all tired yet? Because I could slow down and fill up this tank. Wow. And then she can't lose you in the store. Can't leave you in the car. Got to be dressed warm. Because the school would be like, what are you doing in a t-shirt and no shoes on your feet and it's snowing? Okay, now. Then when you get sick at daycare or in kindergarten because somebody couldn't keep it up, couldn't keep up with all everything that needs to be kept up from age zero all the way till 4 or 5, and you catch a cold. That would happen if you end up in the hospital. That's all night long that she got to miss all this day of work. And you busy cussing her out and don't think she ain't crap. That's a mighty woman, honey. That's a mighty woman. That's a mighty man if they willing to stay in the game. Everything. Just sit down and list every year she got to do something for you. And then she got to Halloween costumes. Your birthday party. She's beautiful. Thanksgiving. Christmas. Christmas Eve. You want lights in the windows. Ooh, mommy, can we have... Ooh, she can never get any rest. That's why some mothers just sit down there. Okay. And they try to stay as nice as they can. And then she's thinking of you getting a car. You don't have to say nothing. Or think about getting you a pass for the metro. And she got to worry about, are you educated enough to go to college or find a job? And you're busy cussing her out, telling her off, and getting smart. How belittling. And you don't even have a clue. A clue. Because if she had not done nothing and keep you dumb and taught your ABCs backwards and not how to count or anything and didn't do one thing with you, who did it? She did. He didn't do nothing. He just dropped the word. She went through that physical thing, and that's no insult on anyone who's into the religious thing. Stop it. Come out your deepness sometime. I get people for being too deep. Then you get smart with police officers. Everybody needs to quit getting smart. Turn to ladies and gentlemen, because you don't know and you have no clue of what your mothers and fathers have gone through. Don't argue with nobody. Some dads couldn't deal with me. I can't deal with this, man. I gotta go. I didn't think kids was all about this. I mean, you got to do everything. And you got to teach them how to use a fork. And teach them how to use a spoon. And how to hold them. You don't want them in society going like, or eating with their hands. And stop licking that plate. And don't lick that wall. And what do you have in your mouth? Come over here, boy. Girl, if you don't get over here. Oh, just. Then you want to watch all these things on TV. And you got to have a computer. And you got to have one of them special calculators for school. Is there anything else you need to say? Can you be better than your mother? Lot of you can. They are terrific people. Respect them. Those who have fathers, can you be better than your daddy? Then you just want to get in more and more trouble. It just makes them cry. Because they done all this for you to make one mistake. There you go, dropping your parents to follow your friends. Isn't that amazing? What? You're not that faithful to anybody. Especially the one that's been taking care of you. Because you've been all about me, myself, and I. And then some of y'all want to get into this drug thing. And they're going to say, well, I'm trying to help my family. No, you're not. No, you're not. Helping your family doesn't constitute you being arrested. And most people who sell drugs get in trouble and get arrested. Or do foolish things. Like put all their stuff on Facebook and you're snorting and you're all that. What? Smoking stuff on Facebook. Showing pounds and pounds. And look at this right here. You're not doing your mother a favor. You're being silly. Think about some things. Go in your room. Write it all down. Slow this tape down. Rewind it and rewind it. And that's just to get you up to kindergarten. Because kindergarten, they got a whole other set of rules before you go into public school. All that paperwork. And there's another batch of shots you got to get. Immunization. And you got means she got to take off work and go get them shots. She got to sit there at the doctor's office and hopefully you're not sick again. Think about that. That's enough to make me cry for some kid who doesn't respect that. I don't care if you're rich. I don't care if you're poor. Look at it. And one day you're going to have kids. All right? And I wish the men would just stay in the game and go through it. With everything that needs to be done, it takes two. In the United States, to raise a child, it takes a village. There's grandparents that will help out. Oh, wow. And then Lord knows they're trying to keep, if there's any pedophiles around there, they got to keep you safe because they don't want nobody to put their fingers or their tongues or their penises on you in any way, shape, or form or at any orifice. Look up what an orifice is. Come on, guys. You got to get speed it up, get with the game. Mothers and fathers are not maids and butlers. They don't wait on you hand and foot while you sit around and complain. Like a person in a restaurant. Excuse me. I need this. Okay, and you see her waiting on tables. Be so ignorant. Don't snap your fingers. That's why they say, I can't wait until this piece of a child. And you don't want your parents to be so upset at you. Because all you are is ignorant. Willfully ignorant. Just doing it just to be doing it. Copping an attitude. Until you have a baby. You're going to see the light till the man above put one on you. Yeah. You'll never have a day of rest again. And when you do, somebody will always be waking you up. And you'll never have a lot of money. Because all your money going to go into that child. And you're going to always worry about bills. You'll always worry about what in the world could be going on with my child. And is my child talking to me? And understanding everything that I'm saying, and that I do care for them. And that I am looking out for their safety. I just got to go to work, and I got to be fresh, and I got to be rested before I get fired. And I worry every day, am I going to get fired from my job? Because I got mouths to feed. Does my child really care? They will when they get older. So I'm giving y'all a clue in this right now. You think you can do a lot of things. Like a lot of people think they can fly until you fall flat on your face. A lot of people think they can get that football because you see them doing that. And you, do you know how many hits that quarterback has taken? You think it's easy to get to the foul shot line, nobody's around, and the game stops, and you the star, and you get to the line. Let me see how many times you make it. It takes practice. It takes a lot. You got to put a lot into life. And you don't have time to be doing this. Maybe some people did these things. These 100 most repeatedly broken laws. They did these things as a cop-out. To go to prison. To go to jails. To go into juvie. Because they can't take it. If your parents ask you to straighten up your room, that's a little help. Could you watch so-and-so? That's a little help. If they take a swig and they ain't took a drink in years, hey. Drinking, a drunk, and a drink. Learn your English. All right? I know a lot of teens get started because I had a lot of teens on my beat. A lot of teens on my beat. And you weren't fair to your parents. Nah, they weren't fair at all. All right? Teenagers don't rule. You can't even support yourself. Because hopefully the parents, a lot of parents in America say yes, yes, yes. They don't say a lot of no's. There's a lot of happy teens around here. They even foster care do pretty good. They got to do it all. And thank goodness you can go to the bathroom on your own. Come on, guys. Y'all got to find a way. We got to set a new trend about loving your parents. All right? So understand, Don't add things like, I'm getting ready the next 10 subjects right here. You don't need to add this because you're bored. Pick up a good book. Surprise your mother, Mom. I'm going to be a lawyer. What? Why she doing all that work? Dad doing all that work. Now, dads come home because they doubt something. Yeah. Mom's always on your side. Then dads, because they're out there in that rough world. It's a lot. Yeah, but I'm going to do it anyway. I'm starting out with cocktails. Be a lawyer. And y'all ain't going to have to do all that. And I appreciate you taking time out. It's a lot. And write down everything. And sit down with your mom and look it up on the internet. Everything that has to be done before you even hit kindergarten. Or they ain't going to let you in. Daycare, or they're not going to let you in. Now that you're off to elementary school, because you only go to kindergarten for like half a day. And if you don't have it all together, up to a certain level, by first grade, you're not getting in. They're going to put you through kindergarten twice. Tell me that's a lot of work. Don't dismiss the work. It's physical work besides the yard. Then they have to teach you too, because if they die, you have to be self-sufficient. Nobody gonna do your stuff for you. Drugs is not the easy way, because a lot of people gotta get caught. My mother needs some money, and she wouldn't have to go to work like that. No, she gotta do everything else. Why don't you pick up the pieces at the house and stop evaluating and checking things out? Let her go to work and you do some of that house stuff. How about that one? Oh. That's how you do it. You'll go out and sell drugs and got her worrying, and then she's still stuck with the household stuff so much. No matter how much money she gets, she still would need a maid. A help around the house. Not a mouth. A help around the house, guys. 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Don't always be on the phone. Don't always be running at your friends. Help. Help. It's a nice trade-off. I think she'd be happy if you do the dishes and do them right. Look after things. Maybe she can get some sleep. Maybe she can get a lot of sleep. She can sleep every day. As soon as you come in, you studying. Okay, I got it. Going upstairs, go to sleep, Mom. I got it. I'm not going outside. I ain't doing nothing like that. Because you got from 18, when you graduate high school, and it is hell. She can't let nothing go. All the way to your 118. That's your time. What's wrong with the first 18 years? Help her out. Help him out. All right? Now listen. Don't go in the opposite direction. They got to get you out. Now you done spent their money. And it's so sad. It's so sad. Okay, elements. Make it up. The crime of trafficking. Now hold on. Let me run through this real quick. Trafficking, the next couple lessons, drug manufacturing, DWI, possession, drug tools, drug use, drug selling, smuggling, concealed weapons, and weapons charge. Those are hefty, all right? And that's all the way up to lesson number... Well, that's 10 lessons, back to back to back. That's why I said, stay in order. Let's get this thing done so you can help mom and dad. And they can trust you. And they can go, my kid can go to the store. I know you're not going to steal because he knows fines and the penalties. Thank you, Lisa. Thank you, Lisa. Can I get a little thank you? Thank me! I'm being everybody's parent. I'm a substitute parent. Listen! I'm doing something. And I love it. That moms and dads wish they had the time to do, and they don't. Okay? All right. So, we on the subject. The next 10 subjects that I am going to just be short and sweet with you. Don't do them. Trafficking. You don't do it now. You don't do it later. You don't do it when you're 150 years old. I don't care if you reach 1,000. These next 10, for real. Alright, guys. You got to do your part now. Because parents, they be doing your Easter shoes. And then they so sad if you get a scratch on them. They got to do your hair and teach you how to do your hair. Got to take you to the barbershop, guys. They got to teach you, like if you on a football team, how to wear your cup. And put on your shoes on the wrong foot. Think about that. How to brush your teeth. And you're going to trade your parents in for a sucker friend. We're going to try to get everybody. Just say, look, man, you need to go spend some time with your parents. I need to spend time with mom. Because some friends just too clingy. They get on you. And they don't want to let go. Some of them just real needy. Y'all got friends like that? Real needy. Ooh, no, that's not a friend. That's a person with a problem and an issue. Okay? They take out. You can't even study. You probably can't halfway watch because they right there. Make sure they, hey, look, Chiquita, Joseph, Johnny, come here. Okay? We all go watch this. And Peter, pull them together. Everybody be quiet. Because it's all about helping the parents out now. Because this stuff has really taken so much money out of homes that could have been used for your education. I look at some of these fines, $10,000, $20,000, $500. $1,000. Another $1,000. Oh my goodness. Another $1,000. $5,000. Ooh, it just goes up and up. And that's just the beginning. The judge can order anything he wants. But you have no business being in the courtroom. In juvenile, I don't care. Adult court, I don't care. It's all about understanding. Now that I give y'all something to think about, make a list. You got your words. You have your words in a special book. Make a list of everything the United States required in order for you to be here. And she kept up with every last one of them. She hung in there as best as she could. That's why mothers get Mother's Day cards. That's why daddy get ties. He's the man. You the man. Because if you could do half of what they did, to get you this far, the 13, 14, 15, 16, and 17, and you one step from 18, you a bad human being. And that's an out-of-sight parent. Listen. Okay. We'll get to take your test. All right? These videos are not rehearsed and they're not edited. I like to talk to you guys. You know that. All right. Getting to know each other more and more, right? Elements making up the crime of trafficking. One, to manufacture, distribute, or dispense a controlled substance. Look up these words. Manufacture. Now you guys can get a little group where somebody can write down the words. Okay, write down the words. Write down the words. But you can stop the videos too. Because the elements are posted in the videos. Okay. That's prior to you hear the siren. I put that in there for you. I thought you would like it. I did. Okay, listen. To manufacture, distribute, dispense controlled substance. Okay. All right. Or to possess with intent to manufacture, distribute, or dispense a controlled substance. Or, number three, to create, distribute, or dispense a counterfeit substance. Now, you can't even fake like parsley. They sell parsley and they go, oh man, they ain't really weed. That's just parsley. You can't do that either. Okay, nothing even looks like it. It can't even look like tea. No. All right. Number four, possess with intent to distribute or dispense a counterfeit substance. All right, now listen. 10 years upwards to life. Wow. And think about, and I want you to look at that list now. I ask you guys to create. Just take your time. Or y'all get together in a group. What things, and it helps you to understand, do I need a baby this early on in life? Sex can be a little fun, but when that baby comes, it ain't no joke. All right? Write down everything, everything and then see how much time you got for rest. And that baby's gonna cry. Can you kill it? No. Can you hurt it? No. And if you hurt your child, you want your child as healthy as can be. Because the healthier your child is, it betters the odds that your kid won't be constantly in your life. That they grow up and flourish and fly like a little bird. And they grow up and go do for themselves and come back and visit you from time to time. How you doing today? Call you. Okay? That's sweet. Come and give you a hug. All right, hug your mothers. Hug your daddies. All right? Don't worry about mommy ain't with daddy. That, leave it alone. You only been here 13 years, 14 years, 15 years, 16 years, 17 years. What do you know? You got to be on. Like I used to say that. What do I know? My mother is 32 years old, 35 years old, I don't know how old she was. I'm like, what do I know? It's like me being in the 13th grade when she over there in the 35th grade. What do you know? Nothing. And it's okay to learn to know nothing. Okay? What could you have known at age one? Most people don't have a memory prior to preschool. Like, not every single day of your life. No, you can't. Nobody can tell me that. Nobody can tell me that. Nobody can tell me that. You don't know if you got enough sleep or you didn't. Nobody can tell. No. And me believe it? Okay, let's move forward on that one. All right, now. Penalty for trafficking. Damage that occur and occur begin at $10,000. Upwards to, Lord knows how much. Plus cost of court. And you know you're going to court over trafficking. Some of these things y'all may not be familiar with, but I'm going to tell you this much. You know, everybody has seen somebody or know somebody that's been to court over trafficking and anything to do with drugs. And it's very real. Alright? Don't be a disappointment to your parents coming across with this bull crap that you're helping them. Because see, that's the common phrase. I'm helping my mom, I was helping my dad, you know. We were struggling. Bull doo-doo. You're making them worry. I was a kid. I was a teen. Mama said, please don't go out there and do what the other kids are doing. Like, you ain't got nothing to worry about. I'd rather fight you first than be your flunky. Wow. Don't do it. That's the attitude I had. And people knew it. Lisa rather fight you first than be your flunky. I'm not flunkying for nobody. You're going to have to step it right here. All right? Listen. If not, they're going to take you down. They're trying to conquer. But y'all, stop it. Be about your families, your communities, making them strong and everybody peaceful and everybody chill. You don't have to live in a rich community to have a loving community. This rich people, a lot of times, I don't mean no harm, they up in them big old houses. They don't know each other's neighbor. They like, who's that? Oh, they so working so hard, but there's nothing wrong with that. Okay, they got it all in control. They know what they know, and they got to go through the same things too. Heartache. A lot of them don't have no nannies. But listen, they don't have a close-knit community. A lot of them don't. A lot of them come in and out of town, in and out of town. They're friends with their coworkers. But that next door neighbor and five, all those kids, no. But let me say something, and I'm not shooting them in the foot. You guys of a lesser income, you got more love to share. So get educated, so you can help your mom and your dad, so you can have something in life. They can be proud of you. You can't help them if you're locked up when they get old, can you? Mom, how come you get it? Baby, I'm sick. And you're feeling bad because you know you done wrong. Don't do it. Mom, you going to be able to come up this Christmas? No, I was in a car accident. I'm sorry I didn't tell you. Yeah, you got her all bent out of shape. So you stay locked up for a few years, you're going to mellow out. Mellow out instead of getting locked up. How about that? Wasting taxpayer dollars and stuff and embarrassing your mom. embarrassing your family. Embarrassments. They have so much in it for you. I mean, they're really, really proud of you. You know, learn your ABCs. Wow. A, B, C, D, E, J. No. And they got photos of you and everything. And you're going to be a big old disappointment. Don't do that. Don't willfully. Don't do it. All right, leave all these next 10 subjects alone, and I mean it. You want people to like you. You don't want to be sitting in a cell with a same sex. And that, let me tell you, anybody stick a thermometer up your behind and it hurts, you wait till they put all them inches in your behind. And ladies, there's some vicious women that think they're men in penitentiaries. And they'll screw you in every orifice you got and make you do some ugly things to them. The guards are not always around. All right? A conspiracy charge can be added to most crimes, which increases or may double your sentence. Let's move forward because we have a lot to discuss. And next we're on to drug manufacturing. But let me tell you, I'm going to do a lot of talking, guys. And I mean it. I mean it. Enough of these excuses as to why you need to sell drugs, take drugs, produce drugs, create drugs, transport drugs. They don't want it. Go to Colorado when you get 18. But please do call back home to your mom. She probably thought she'd have you for a lifetime, a lot of y'all. And if you're locked up right now, I'm here to tell you right now, go in that corner, boo, because she really thought that she had you for a lifetime. You guys, the love of your mommy's life. Wow. And she's so doggone proud of you. You don't want her sitting there telling them stories. Them old stories. Them stories. What you used to be before you got with them friends. Okay? Who ain't taking care of you now. Don't get in it. Good. Everybody back on their own porches. Yay. Okay. All right. You don't suffer from a mental illness. Keep that in mind, guys. If you're suffering, mommy will take care of it. But if you're not, and you're just out there acting like you're crazy. Some mothers go like this. I can't wait till we go. Because I'm done. I tried talking to him and talking to her and all. They seem like they don't want to listen. I done enough. I got pregnant. I did this. I did that. You see how they start talking? That's because you doing it. You fueling it. If you sat down there and just read a book, get your homework assignments done, and do everything you know possible to put a smile on her face. Keep a feather in your daddy's cap. Your grandma and grandpa are just so excited. They're not supposed to just flourish you with money. And just, who do you think you are? Nobody has that right. They taught you how to poop and to pee. And here you go. Like everybody else. They can't wait till you get out there. Some of y'all can't wait till you go. They don't want you back in there either. Because they're so disappointed. So you got to find somewhere in your heart. Forgive yourself. Swinging on the chandeliers of life. Anytime you want to. They asked you to put down the video game. They get tired of hearing that. And some of them, my mother says she don't care. You know why? Because she's tired of dealing with you. She just went on to something else. Go and ask her. If she asked you to put them down one time, and you didn't, and you said, no, go on up there. She don't want to fight with you. But she'd be happy that you get gone. Because you break your mother's heart. I am so tickled that some of you guys want to straighten up. Don't break your mother's heart. That's a hard one to live down. That's the end of that subject right there. Let's keep it right there. Don't break your mother's heart. That's a hard one. Because I'm going to tell you this right here. You know what it is to have a broken heart. Ask me. Is it so easy to forgive? It's not. It's not. And sometimes you don't even know that you broke their heart. And that creates a space and a distance between you guys. That's why you can't You know, some of them don't care. Whatever. You know, broke their heart. You said something or you did something. Shame on you. Some of you guys, you don't think men can suffer broken hearts with the crap that their kids say to them. Don't be so gung-ho to say any and everything that you want. Come out that mouth. Don't you kick your parents. Then want to say, I'm sorry. And eat across and want to take you to McDonald's. Eat across from them. And go tattletale on your parents. Where's the commitment? They what in the world that I have? I can't wait till it's gone. And it catch you in one of them days. And the truth hits. And you go, wow, that's deep. Your mom don't want you back. Then there you go, wanting to commit. But you did it. But you did it. But I'm telling you right now, if it hasn't happened, don't get into it. All right, guys? And if it has happened, and you're in that situation, I bet you when you get finished with these, and you present it, she go, what is that? That was an online course that I took. It's about the law. You go, what is a cop to? Yeah, well, you know, just take them. And you watch what happens. It's an online course that I took. I did all the tests and I graduated. Don't you tell me that's not going to make a mother and a father happy. Or grandparents. That you took time out of being this off the chain teenager. Selfish, unforgiving. Think of nobody but yourselves. Not think about nobody else in the United States. And you do something like this? Now maybe they can rest a little bit. Because cops have seen a lot. Ungrateful children. Rich, poor, fat, thin, black, white, Chinese. It doesn't make a difference, okay? We done seen it all, and we're shocked at the way American children treat their parents. And some have even killed their parents. That's why judges don't care. You better care for yourself. All right, let's move on to the next one. Snap at it. All right, we're on to drug manufacturing.
The weight of my mistakes depends on how I feel. Don't let it bring you down. The weight of what I say depends on how. But I don't